greatest fullback of all time in studio, Lorenzo Neal with us, 570-1360. You are more than welcome to come hang out, share a story. I know a lot of you have met Lorenzo Neal. We've already had some stories shared, so please, 570-1360, we are here to hang out with Lo Daddy. Lo, there's not a fullback in the Hall of Fame. Do you ever allow yourself to go there in your mind to think that if somebody's going to get in, it's going to be Lorenzo? Do you ever go there in your head?
It was interesting this year that, you know, I was nominated for the Hall of Fame, made to the top 100, you know, nominees on the Hall of Fame. I think just the fact that, like, guys like yourself, my peers and people that I played with who thought you had, Nick, a hell of a career, being an undersized center but still a Pro Bowl guy because of your leverage, because of your wrestling background, and you would dominate the game. Why? Because the want to and having the heart. And I think wrestling is an unbelievable sport, and I think it helped me become the football player that I was. And I think the biggest thing is, I know there's not going to be a true fullback. You look at the Larry Zonka, you look at Franco Harris, but there's guys that's deserving of the Hall of Fame.
You don't think there's ever going to be a true fullback in the Hall of Fame?
I don't know.
What a
man.
Shame.
It really is, because I look at guys like Moose Johnson. What he did for Emmitt Smith is unbelievable. I look at a guy, when you think about the guy, if you think about John Rathman, think about what Rathman, the way that he played the game, you know, with the San Francisco 49ers.
Yep.
Sam Gash is another guy that was a thumper that should have been in there. Another guy people don't talk about, man, but you watch what he did, one of the best pass-receiving fullbacks that the game has ever seen. Larry Sinners, Arizona Cardinals. When you think about those guys, if you talk about just the pure running fullback, a guy that ran just as well as Zonka, just as well, if you think about Larry Zonka, was a bad boy, but a guy who ran just as well should be in the Hall of Fame. That was one of the best running fullbacks ever, is Mike Allstott. Purdue guy. So I really believe there should be five or six of these guys in the Hall of Fame. I think that it's wrong.
It's such a vital part of, and it may not be currently,
right.
It may not be part of the current iteration of what we're watching in the NFL, but through the generations, it has been such a crucial part to success. You were LT's eyes. He trusted you.
Absolutely.
He had a faith in you that you were going to find the right hole and you were going to lead him through that hole. It made his job that much easier.
And to that point, it's just like when you think about what happened in the NFL, you're like, when are they going to get a kicker and our punter? And then it happened. Why? And people said these guys sometimes don't even punt once in a game. They don't even punt five times in a game. But yet and still, because they're able to change the game, they're in the Hall of Fame now. So I definitely believe that fullbacks should be in the Hall of Fame.